Bezrat Hashem, with Hashem's loving grace, welcome to Amuna Beams with your host Laser Brody. Today's podcast is entitled The Gate of Geula, and it's amazing Amuna look at what's happening right now in front of our own eyes in light of what Tzaddikim wrote hundreds of years ago. The Passover Haggadah teaches us what the Torah tells us in Parshas Bo, that the Geula from Egypt, the redemption of our people from slavery back in Egypt, was implemented by the Almighty Himself without activating any angels or any heavenly emissaries. 18 years ago, I asked my esteemed teacher, the Militzer Rebbe Shlita, when does the Almighty do things by Himself and when does He delegate tasks to the angels? Well, the Rebbe's answer, which I documented in my Hebrew book Priya Be'er and Parshat Bo, is as follows, and I quote, "During a war, a prime minister doesn't have the time to delegate responsibilities to his ministers. He therefore assumes all the portfolios himself and makes critical decisions speedily and with no bureaucracy. The same goes for the Geula, the full and final redemption of our people. Things will happen swiftly, so the Almighty won't have time to delegate responsibility to the angels. He'll do everything himself." That's the end of a quote. Is that not an accurate picture of what's happening today? On both sides of the ocean, life has changed more dramatically in a few short weeks than anyone would have ever believed. If some fiction novel predicted that the streets would be empty on Seder night in the year 2020, would you have believed it? If someone would have told you that after the Israeli government decided to allow public transportation on Shabbat, would you have believed that not only would public transportation be ceased on Shabbat, but it would stop entirely? Not only that, would you ever believe that stadiums, nightclubs, bars, and restaurants would be completely locked down? Or how about the fact that synagogues and yeshivas have been closed down too? These are pieces to a puzzle that confuse people, and few people could put them into a coherent picture. But we do know one thing. They all defy nature in such a way that they could be nothing other than Hashem. Okay, we can understand the logic of Hashem taking away stadiums and nightclubs. It's Hashem wants us to be more spiritual. But what's the rationale behind Hashem closing down synagogues in a way never before experienced, even the darkest hours of our history? Our sages teach that the darkest dark precedes the lightest light. In other words, such calamities as wars and natural disasters and pandemics precede the bright light of Geula. Well, earlier today, I spoke to my esteemed friend, Rabbi Moshe Bunamintz Shlita. He's the head of the Land of Israel Mitzvahs Koilo in Ashdod. And he showed me a mind-boggling excerpt from the Kabbalistic writings of Rabbi Moshe Chaim Lutzato, who everyone knows as the Ramcha'l of sacred and blessed memory, which the Ramcha'l wrote about 300 years ago. Here's a passage that, to best of my knowledge, has never been translated. It's from page 248 in the Yalkut Yediot Emet. This is the second volume of the anthology of the Ramcha'l's writings from a discourse entitled Ma'amar HaGeula, the Discourse of Redemption. Now listen carefully to what the Ramcha'l writes, and again I'm quoting, "When the Holy Temple was destroyed, the gate where every blessing and all peace and abundance was closed. Once this tremendous gate was closed, tiny windows were opened. These tiny windows received tiny mandates from the great mandate of the tremendous gate, which King Solomon alluded to in Song of Songs, chapter 2, passage 9. He overlooks through the windows and peeks through the cracks. These windows shall not be closed during the entire days of diaspora, otherwise the world would be destroyed in one moment. But when the Geula, the full redemption of our people, shall arrive, may it be soon, the great locked gate shall be reopened, and no one will remember the little windows anymore, as the Gemara in Tractate Brachot reminds us that one monarchy doesn't touch another. In other words, there are no overlapping mandates. As the great gate will be rebuilt, the tiny windows will gradually disappear. But before the great light of the great gate will be revealed, the light of the windows will decrease, and it will be a time of great darkness, but it won't last long. Once the rebuilding of the Great Gate will be completed above, it will be revealed below, as is known to those with esoteric wisdom. That's the end of the Ramcha'l's quote. Rabbi Mintz told me that the Sasover Rebbe of Bnei Brak, he says that the windows that the Ramcha'l were speaking about, these are the synagogues, and they're now all closed today, exactly as the Ramcha'l said they were. And according to a government announcement this morning, it doesn't look like they're going to be reopened soon. So whether or not the Ramcha'l was talking about today, no one could be absolutely sure. But one thing is true. The world is learning that nothing is under anyone's control anymore. And soon, there will be no other place to look for explanations but skyward. And the seemingly cryptic writings of the Ramcha'l, they're making more and more sense today. But we do know one thing for sure. Once the truth of Hashem's monarchy is revealed and we witness the Geula, the full redemption of our people, it won't be worth much if someone comes forth and wants to jump on the wagon of Amunah. Oh yeah, I believe in Hashem too. No, or I want to do tshuva. I want to do tshuva too. No, now is the time. Now is the time to strengthen Amunah. Now is the time to strengthen tshuva. Now is the time to come back to Hashem when things are not yet clear and apparent. Because once they are clear and apparent, tshuva and Amunah aren't going to be worth much. And that's what the Ramcha'l tells us at the end of his discourse, that we must be strong in yearning for Hashem, and the only strength of heart that enables a person to keep going in these dark times is Emunah. So that's the order of the day, to strengthen our Emunah. And may Hashem send us all a complete salvation in the nearest future. Amen. God bless.